Hi, welcome back to my channel. And now today we are gonna talking about top strategy games that focus on Pacific War during World War II. Mostly, Pacific War is won by naval supremacy by either US Navy and Allies or Japanese Empire. But there are also a decisive land battle that turn the tide of the war. So without further ado, let's begin our list. PTO is a turn-based strategy game that focus on Pacific theater on World War II. In this game, you can play as United States or Japanese Empire. You will lead the nation, deploying your ships and army, spending your budget, and choose your general and admiral to lead on the field. The gameplay consists of short scenario with some objective, and long scenario that make you controlling the Pacific theater completely. Despite PTO lack of visual graphics, it is still interesting game as their mechanics and UI still acceptable for me. For PTO 2, there are a lot improvement from the predecessor, like visual graphics, diplomacy, espionage, and research, and some battle visual that add more fun for this game. If you like turn-based strategy and historical game, this game is for you. One of unique RTS game that has micromanagement is Pacific Storm. It has strategic gameplay that you can manage your nation like doing research, building ships and fortification, and others. While on tactical gameplay, you will lead a squadron or group or fleet to destroy enemy base or fleet. The unit variety is huge from the fighter, bomber, battleships, even the submarines. The micromanagement also feels challenging. You must resupply the fuel and the ammo, not mention the crew of your fleet. Overall, Pacific Storm is a good real-time strategy game that offers a good balance between strategy and action. However, the game has a dense interface that requires a lot of micromanaging, and it has occasional game crash and bugs that can affect the gameplay experience. Warplane Pacific is turn-based strategy war game which covers all the nations at war in the Pacific theater from December 1941 to 1945 on massive game scale. The game also features accurate representation of the units and equipment using during the war. The game also includes realistic weather conditions, supply lines, and terrain features that affect gameplay. The game is designed to be played at an operational level, which means that players must manage entire fleets and air group. Overall, Warplane Pacific is a great game for those interested in World War II, strategy games, and the Pacific theater of the war. Actually, Sudden Strike for the Pacific War is only DLC for the main game, but it has two campaigns with a total of 10 missions based on the Southeast Asian campaign of World War II. Lead the Japanese force on to invade Singapore, the British military stronghold in South Asia, and take over strategically important targets. Take command of the Allied force during the first major offensive against the Empire of Japan in Guadalcanal up until the first battle of Iwo Jima. The Pacific War DLC brings some new features like flamethrowers, amphibious vehicle, large controllable aircraft carriers, advanced air combat, as well as new unit skills. Overall, Sudden Strike for the Pacific War is a good DLC for fans of the base game, but it may not be worth for players who are looking for a completely new experience. Victory at Sea Pacific is a real-time strategy game set in the Pacific theater of World War II. You can switch between commanding the entire Pacific theater to zooming down to take control of individual ships and flights of planes. There are more than 100 ship class to choose with, dozens of aircraft types, and ports spanning across Pacific Ocean. Victory at Sea Pacific is a good real-time strategy game that offers a good balance between strategy and action. Overall, Victory at Sea Pacific is a good game for fans of real-time strategy games set in World War II, but it may not be worth for players who are looking for a completely new experience. War in the Pacific Admirals Edition is a turn-based strategy game that simulates the Pacific theater of World War II. The game allows the player to control naval, air, and ground forces and covers the entire Pacific theater of World War II. The game features a high level of detail and historical accuracy with over 40,000 unique units and 200 different ship classes. The game has a good balance between strategy and simulation, with a focus on logistics and supply. The game has a good balance between strategy and simulation, and it has a high replayability value. However, the game has a steep learning curve and a dense interface that may not be suitable for casual players. Overall, War in the Pacific Admirals Edition is a good game for fans of the turn-based strategy games that set in World War II. Strategic Mine Pacific is a turn-based strategy game set during World War II, respecting the war between the USA and the Empire of Japan waged in the Pacific Ocean. The game features a high level of detail and historical accuracy with over 350 different units and 60 different ship classes. The game allows the players to control naval, air, and ground forces and covers the entire Pacific theater of World War II. The game allows players to play both sides of the story, and it features in-depth naval and air combat as well as some different strategy mechanics. Overall, Strategic Mine Pacific is a solid turn-based tactics game that offers a unique focus on naval warfare during World War II. Aircraft Carrier Survival is a strategical management game that puts players in control of a naval fleet during World War II on Pacific Theater. The game allows players to take command of an aircraft carrier and manage all aspects of it, from the officer and crew to the planes and anti-aircraft turrets. Players must assess which threats needs to be dealt with first in order to survive, using maneuvers, aircraft, and whatever else they can to stay alive. Use intel collected during recon missions to prepare pilots and aircraft for large operations, target and identify opponents before choosing attack directions and deciding the sequence of targets and maneuvers. Overall, Aircraft Carrier Survival is a challenging and rewarding strategical management game that offers a lot of depth and replayability. War on the Sea is a strategy game that simulates naval combat during World War II that focuses on South Pacific theater. The game offers a dynamic campaign where players can play as either the Allied force or Imperial Japan, and features over 50 class of playable ship. The game has a mid-level degree of simulation, and no one element of it stands out as particularly impressive. The game features real-time naval combat, theatrical external view gameplay, tactical control of aircraft, and historical missions based on naval engagement. Players can fight fires, counterfloat compartments, and repair ships, and sink ships using realistic buoyancy physics. Overall, War on the Sea is a good choice for World War II Navy enthusiasts, and the Pacific Guadalcanal campaign is a great fun. Order of Battle World War II is a turn-based strategy game that allows players to take command of the armies of various nations during World War II. For Pacific campaign, you can play as Japanese Empire for controlling Pacific Ocean and China territory, or play as United States to push back the Japanese to their land. To play Pacific campaign, you need some DLC like Rising Sun, US Pacific, US Marines, Morning Sun, and Burma Road. The game has a detailed supply system that requires players to manage their resources carefully to keep their unit operational. The game features a wide variety of units, each with its strengths and weakness, which adds to the strategic depth of the game. Overall, Order of Battle World War II is a deep and complex turn-based strategy game that offers a lot of content for players to enjoy. So that's our line, Admiral. With this list, I hope it helped you discover some new Pacific War games to try out. Let me know in the comments which ones are your favorites, and if I miss any that you think should be included. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video. See ya!